So in a moment of revelation, we can discover that neither lahat po ng mga sinasabi natin dito sa pulpito or even the things we are do for God, they only account for the spiritual impact of our ministry because of prayer. Kaya po napakahalaga na tayo po ay may mga partners in prayer. Ang una ko pong partner sa aking paggawa sa Panginoon ay ang aking may bahay. Pangalawa po ang aking anak na si Chap. So we need somebody to pray for us wherever and whenever we do the things for the glory of God. Because it is our partnership with people of prayer like you, those who are standing at the back praying for the leaders, that makes us effective. So gaano man po kaganda ang mensahe natin, kung ito ay hindi pinagpala ng Panginoon, hindi po ito magiging epektibo at hindi ito makakapagpala sa mga tao. Amen. C.H. Spurgeon continued, "When my prayer partners lay hands on me and I see them praying over the auditorium, I receive a new strength." Thank you, prayer partners. Because when every time I stand here, I receive a new strength because of your interceding. Physically, mentally, according to Spurgeon, spiritually and emotionally, I feel prepared to receive the power of God, and that has allowed my ministry to have great impact on people's lives. So yun po ang dapat nating gawin na mangyari sa ating mga buhay. Kahit po mga ordinary po tayong Bible study leader, take somebody as your prayer partner. Amen. Blessing you, praying for you, that God will do something great in what you are doing for the Lord. Prayer changes us. Prayer changes us by drawing us closer to God, changing and molding us into His likeness. So ito po ang isa sa ginagawa ng pananangin sa ating mga buhay. He is molding us into His likeness. Ang sabi po ni the prayer of David in Psalm chapter 25 verse 4 and 5 describes the process that prayer takes a person through, because David understood the power of prayer. Amen. David understood, naiintindihan po ni David ang kapangyarihan ng panalangin as a personal change agent. Ang sabi po sa Psalm 25 verse 4 and 5, sabi po niya, "Show me the path where I should walk, O Lord. Point out the right road for me to follow. Lead me by your truth and teach me, for you are the God who saves me. All day long I put my hope in you." In this passage, it contains three key phrases. Show me, teach me, and lead me. When God shows us His standards and His will for our lives, though it is not easy, it always requires us to grow and change. Amen. Once we accept what God would show us, He is able to teach us. And when we are teachable and growing, He is finally able to guide us or lead us into His plan and purpose. Amen. So napakaganda po na naunawaan natin kung ano ang kahalagahan ng panalangin. Even David the king believes that prayer is a personal change agent. It shows us, it teaches us, and it guides us into His plan and purpose. Ang pangalawa po na nais kong dalhin sa inyo is about intercession. One of the great things about prayer is intercession. The term intercession literally means to come upon, to meet with, and to come between. When used in the context of prayer as it is here, it takes on a special meaning. To intercede is to stand between God and someone. Amen. So when you intercede for me, when I'm in Cotabato, you stand with God and for me. And that is interceding. It is asking God for blessing for others is called also intercession. So when you intercede for somebody, you are blessing him. You are asking God to bless him. Because intercession is praying for others and it is important part of our devotion time. So, sa ating pong mga devotion, hindi lamang po tayo nananalangin. Let us also intercede for people. Amen. For people, for leaders of the church who work outside or far away in the church. It not only benefits others and connects us to God, but it also helps us. Amen. Napakahalaga po that we can intercede for people. Not only praying for them, but blessing them, asking God to bless them through our interceding. So ang sabi po ni Paul kay Timothy, I urge then, first of all, that requests, prayers, intercession, and thanksgiving be made for everyone, for kings and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. This is good, Paul said to Timothy. And it pleases God, our Savior, who wanted all men to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth. Do you believe, church? Kung ano ang sinasabi ng Proverbs 29, verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. Amen. But when a wicked man rules, the people cry. The people groan. It's election time again. Amen. Let us pray. Let us intercede for these people who are running in the government. Let us pray that God will put righteous people in authority. For what reason? As Paul said, so that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. Kung ang mga mauupo po na mga otoridad sa ating gobyerno ay mga tao, let us say, the righteous people, I'm sure and I believe we will all live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. Kaya po, hindi po ako nangangampanya sa inyo. No? This coming election po, manalangin po tayo. Manalangin tayo na ang Panginoon ay kikilos sa buhay ng mga tao ito. No po? Na tumatakbo po sa mga posisyon sa gobyerno, that God will put people, righteous people in authority so that the people will rejoice. Manalangin po tayo na huwag pong maihalal ang mga tao na ang kanilang motibo ay pansarili lamang dahil tayo po ay iiyak kapag po tayo ay nandoon sa ganung sitwasyon. Amen. So, ito pong darating na election. Maging wise po tayo at manalangin po tayo that God will put righteous people in authority so that the Philippines will rejoice and will not cry and will not groan. Amen. Hallelujah. Because Paul said, no doubt, walang duda, sabi ni Paul. Paul intended for Timothy to pray for the conversion of those in authority and to come to a knowledge of the truth. So kung ang pangatao po sa ating gobyerno ay hindi po mananampalataya, let's pray, na po, manalangin po tayo that they will be converted. Amen. That they will be converted and to come to a knowledge of the truth that comes from the living God. At kung sila po ay makakilala sa Panginoon, naniniwala po tayo na sila rin po ay gagamitin ng Panginoon para sa kapayapaan at kabanalan ng ating pamumuhay. Amen. Gusto ko pong magtapos dito. Although we can say that it's a little early. The Apostle Paul believed that through intercession, people could be changed. Naniniwala po ba tayo doon? People could be changed. Through your interceding, marami pong mangyayari. Marami mga posibleng magaganap doon sa mga malalayong lugar. When you intercede, ang mga taong nagugutom ay nagkakaroon ng pagkain. When you intercede for missionaries out there, marami po ang nadadala sa Panginoon at nakakilala sa Kanya. Through your intercession, marami po mga imposible na nagiging posible. At ito po, and even Paul believe that through this form of prayer, the intercession, people could be changed. Because intercession is the process that links those who need to be changed and the one who can bring about change. So ito po yung nauna-unawan natin. No, ulitin ko po. Intercession is the process that links those who need to be changed and the one who can bring change. It links God and the people whom you are interceding. Amen. So napakahalaga po na tayo po ay nananalangin at nag-intercede. Not only for our church, not only for our leaders like us, but also for those in authority and even to the farthest part of this earth. Because many people, they are blinded with the truth that comes from God. Kaya po, kung tayo po'y nag-intercede, naniniwala po tayo, mayroong ginagawa ang Panginoon na posible sa mga dakong lugar na kung saan dinadala ang mabuting balita. Our prayers are the link between God's inexhaustible, endless, and boundless resources and people's need. Naniniwala po ba kayo na ang Diyos natin ay mayaman? Amen. Amen. So our prayers, ang ating pong panalangin, ito po ay nag-uugnay, na po, between God's inexhaustible, endless, and boundless resources and people's need. Ano po ba ang pangangailangan ng ating iglesia? Manalangin po tayo. At naniniwala ako, the inexhaustible, endless, and boundless resources, ibubus po yan ng Panginoon. Kung tayo ay sama-sabang nananalangin. Amen! The church and even the pastors, let us come together in prayer. Amen. Kaya po ako nagpapasalamat. We started the core group of pastors and leaders praying at 5 o'clock. Pwede niyo po kaming samahan through interceding for us that God will truly move in our hearts. Amen. And do the impossible to become possible. Amen. So when we intercede, we stand in the gap between the need and the satisfaction of the need. So nakita po ba natin ngayon kung bakit napakahalaga, not only we are praying, but also we are interceding. Because when we intercede, when you and I intercede, we stand in the gap between the need and the satisfaction of the need. Ang ibig pong sabihin nun, we stand in the gap sa Diyos na nagbibigay at nagkakaroon ng lahat at doon sa nangangailangan. So intercessory prayer clearly pleases God and is expected to be part of our daily lives. And it helps us to know God's heart. Kaya nga po, sa ating pong panalangin, hindi po ba natin nadidiscover kung ano ang puso ng ating Panginoon? No? Because intercession is the act of praying with God on behalf of someone else. It is a selfless act and is considered by some people to be the highest form of prayer. Thank you, Lord, for the people who intercede for me at this moment. Romans chapter 8 verse 26 says, in the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groans that words cannot express. Ano pong ibig sabihin nun? The Holy Spirit groans. The Holy Spirit cries with us. So when you cry, the Spirit groans with us and feels the burdens of our weaknesses and suffering. But the Spirit does more than groaning. Apo? Alam, dapat ka po yung ating maunawaan. The Spirit does more than groaning or than crying for us, with us. He prays for us in His groaning so that we might be led into the will of God. So ito po ang dapat nating malaman. When we pray, the Holy Spirit prays for us in His groaning so that we might be led into the will of God. Ano po ba ang kalooban ng Panginoon? Ano po ba ang vision ng ating iglesia? Kung kalooban po ng Panginoon na ito'y mangyari, ito po ay gagawin niya. Amen. Because wala pong imposible sa mga taong nananampalataya. We do not always know God's will. We do not always know how to pray. But the Spirit intercedes so that we might live in the will of God in spite of suffering. Whoa, passion for God. Compassion for men.